We have better and better quality textures available, and repetitions are not too common issue anymore. However, sometimes we still have to deal with problems like this if we need a specific map. You can see the edges of the maps are clearly visible, and we cannot use it like that in our renders. So how can we do it for the map to be seamless? I'll add a bit of the working space here so we can improve the texture. We need to get rid of these visible edges and replace those side parts of the map, so the left part matches the right and the top with the bottom. Firstly, I copy the texture to the right. I select the connection of those maps and use the generative fill. As always, we can choose from various options. Here we go, the seam disappeared. For me, the quality is good enough, but you can see the difference if you zoom in closely. If you need a better resolution, just select smaller pieces and generate one by one. To make it more understandable for you, I'll name the maps. Now, we have to copy the right part of the generative fill on another side to make sure we have a seamless connection. I copy the original map and the generative fill though to make it easier to position it in the right place. To make it easier to adjust, I turn off the generative fill layer. Make sure you're copying both layers though. Great, it's in the right place. Now we can turn on the layers. I have to delete the part of the original map to make sure we still have it seamless on the right side. Awesome, I select the original map with Ctrl to mask only what we need. I merge all the visible layers on top and use the original map as a mask. So to sum up, right now we have an original map with the corresponding parts of the generative fill on both sides. I copy it on both sides so we can check if it all works well. Here we go, it's working on both sides. We still need the top and the bottom to be done the same way. Let's copy the map to the top. I organize the layers so it's easier for you to see what is going on. Select the part where the top edge is and use the generative fill. Choose the best option from all. Remember, if you don't like the result, you can generate them again. Okay, now I copy the layers the same way as before. Don't forget to delete the part where the edge is there. Merge the layers and mask them out. Okay, as we have everything done here, we can crop the image to the original texture. It should be seamless now. We can check it with the pattern preview. Here we go. We can see the repetition, but the texture is seamless. You cannot tell where the texture finishes, but obviously, we can still improve the final effect. We can see repetition in the places where the bricks stand out, either because of the brightness or the color. I organize the files so it's not getting too messy. I merge everything on top and I call it original. Everything below, I group and call it work in progress, just in case I have to go back. We don't need these layers. First of all, I fix some bricks that don't look good. We can see the weird transition here. I select the part of the brick with the lasso tool and use generative fill to fix the issue. Again, we can choose whatever matches the best. I like this one. Here, we have an issue too. You can investigate the texture further and look for weird places like these ones. Okay, when we zoom out, we can see the repetitive spots of brighter and darker places. For that reason, we can work on the brightness. Create a new layer. We can change the type to soft light, for example. Choose the brush, and with black and white, you can paint over the texture. You can notice that whatever we change influences all the space. With black, we can make the texture darker, while with white, it becomes brighter. The effect is obviously too strong, so we can adjust the flow. I choose flow, not opacity, as it allows us to build up the ink over and over again. We don't need much. 1 or 2% should be enough. Now we can paint over the areas we think are too dark or too bright to make the texture more uniform. We want to avoid the places that stand out a lot, otherwise they will be very repetitive when we map the texture of the object. Work in different zooms to make sure you get the desired effect. It's good to zoom out from time to time to see the bigger picture. Here is the before and after. It's definitely more uniform. But still, there are some areas that stand out quite a lot. We can adjust the color a bit and make the bricks more similar. Add a new layer and change the type to color. Now we can pick the color from one brick and make another more similar to it. Use the brush, hold shift to pick the color. I would be more precise here and paint one brick after another. Otherwise, it will be hard to get a nice result. I will paint over the bricks that stand out the most and are the most vivid. Thanks to that, they will become more uniform and the repetition will be harder to see. Let's see before and after. Yes, it makes a difference. However, I still can't see the issue here. I will go back to my brightness layer and make these bricks lighter. Let's see how we did so far. Okay, I think I can reduce the opacity of this layer. Yes, better. Spend some time on these two effects. Now you can see that some places still stand out, especially these two bricks. I have to do something with this. Here I would use generative fill to make these areas more uniform. As always, we can choose from different options. Way better, but we have a weird connection here. We can quickly fix this manually with the stamp tool. Good enough. We can work longer on this and improve some areas like here manually. It all depends on how close the texture will be used and how it looks on render. I would suggest testing the texture in the 3D software during the work anyway. We can make some final adjustments. You can work more on that if you need, but you know the process. I group the layers together so we can see what has changed. Here is the final result. It looks way better than at the beginning. At the end, just turn off the pattern preview and save them up. If you want to learn how to create beautiful visualizations from start to finish, join our training or watch more tutorials like this one here. Bye-bye!